Long back, do you know how people used to measure the lengths of objects? They used their palms, forearm, or feet to measure the length, of these objects. But these methods never gave accurate results. A very good morning to all of you. Welcome to online class of St. Joseph's Academy. Children, today we are going to start measurement part. And in this first part, we are going to do measurements of length, measures of length. Chapter 16, measures of length of class 3rd, Maths Junior book. So let's start it. Now, nowadays we use a ruler, a metric scale and measuring tape to measure the accurate length and height of the object. So I'm going to make it more clear how we are going to use a scale to measure an object. Okay, so here we have to measure this pencil. Now this is a centimeter scale, children. Now what is a centimeter? The centimeter is a fixed length. We use to measure small length, such as the length of a book, the height of a TV set, and the thickness of a mobile. And centimeter is written as cm in short. So the big mark on the ruler below are 1 centimeter apart. Now you can use a ruler to measure line segments like this A and B. So A, you can take it from 0, and B, where the tip of the pencil is there, that is at 8 centimeter, that is B point. So you can make a line segment here also. So AB, or this measure of, if you measure this pencil, it will be 8 centimeter. Okay, so you are using a scale to measure this pencil, which is a short length. That is 8 centimeter. You find many divisions on the margin of the ruler. Some lines are longer while others are smaller. So the longer lines represent the numbers in line, and the small lines between two lines represent division of centimeter. Okay, children. So by this way, you can measure a small object things. Now here also you can see how to use a ruler to measure. You have to find the side of the ruler you need to measure. Line up the object with the O. Check to see if your ruler is straight, and measure again to check your work. Now small object is, as I told you, in centimeter you measure it, like pencil, stick, comb, book, duster. But a ruler cannot measure all the objects. Okay, and now scale can be of 15 centimeter and 30 centimeter. If you have to measure the long distance or something like that, or things which are long, more than 30 centimeter, then how you're going to measure? You're going to measure by a measuring tape. A measuring tape is used to measure long distance because it will take less time and effort. Now children, we are going to measure the sides of this rectangle with the help of a ruler, a scale, a centimeter scale. So the measurement of a longer side is called length. The measurement of a shorter side is called breadth. So let us take length 2 centimeter, breadth 3 centimeter. Now sum of the sides will be length plus breadth, plus length plus breadth, because two lengths are there and two breadths are there. So add it up. Length 2 centimeter, then breadth 3 centimeter, then again length 2 centimeter and breadth 3 centimeter. When you will add it all, you will get 10 centimeter. Now here we are going to add the measures of all the sides of a triangle. So let us take side 1 2 centimeter, side 2 3 centimeter, and side 3 4 centimeter. When you will add all these up, you will get 9 centimeter. So in this way, you can measure and calculate the sides of the shapes. Children, to measure length, we use standard units, centimeter, meter, and kilometer. This is what we are going to discuss in this chapter. Now, let us first discuss about centimeter. Centimeter can be written as cm. It is used to measure short length and short height objects. Okay, like example for table and chair. Next standard unit is meter. It is written as m, a small letter m, and we use meter to measure long length, like length of a room, length of a clothes, and short distance, like distance between kitchen and bedroom, that can be measured in meter. And also we use it to measure the long height, or long height of the object, that is height of a tree or a building. The next standard unit is kilometer. It is written as km, small letter km. Now it is used to measure long distance, like distance between two cities, that we use kilometers. We measure in kilometers. So in this way, children, you measure, and kilometer is the biggest unit among all these. Centimeter, meter. Now here, children, I have explained in ascending order which unit is biggest and which is smallest. Now when I say millimeter, which is written in small letter mm, so this is just a tip of a pencil, your nail or your pencil. When I measure objects in centimeter, it is just a small object. When you have to measure, you take centimeter, and when you have to measure long objects, then we use meter, and the long distance, then we use kilometer. So millimeter is the smallest, then centimeter, then meters, then kilometers. And what relation they have, that I will explain you now. Length refers to the distance from one point to another, and the base unit of length in metric system is the meter, and it is represented by m. Now metric units, children, normally we measure in metric units length as a meter. Its unit is meter, and it is represented by m. 1 kilometer has 1,000 meters. That means 1,000 meters will make 1 kilometer. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. That means 100 centimeter has 1 meter, and 1 meter is equal to 1,000 millimeter. Now, children, we are going to understand the conversion of length. Now, when we have to change from centimeter to millimeter, we multiply with 10, because centimeter is bigger than millimeter. But when we have to convert millimeter to centimeter, we will divide it by 10. Why? Because 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. Similarly, you can see here in the meter and centimeter what relation they have. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. And when we change meter to centimeter, we multiply with 100. And when we change centimeter to meter, we divide it by 100. Now, what relation kilometer and meter have? 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meter. Now, when kilometer is converted into meter, we multiply it by 1,000. And when we have to change meter to kilometer, we divide it by 1,000. Now, children, we will understand the relation between meters and centimeters, and more clearly we will understand how we can change it, the units. Now, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. That means 100 centimeters make 1 meter. When 100 centimeter will be there, it will be equal to 1 meter. When we have to change meter to centimeter, we will multiply by 100. And when we will change centimeter to meter, we will divide by 100. Let us see some examples. Now, 4 meter is given and you have to change into centimeter. So what you will do, because meter is bigger than centimeter, you will multiply 4 to 100, because 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So when you will multiply 4 with 100, it will become 400 centimeter. That means 4 meter is equal to 400 centimeter. Similarly, 12 meter, this you have to change it. So again, you will multiply with 100. So it will become 1200 centimeter. Now, children, we will do the exercise 16A given on the page number 132. So let us do the first one, change into centimeters. Here you have to do convert into centimeters. Now, first part A question, 3 meter. That you have to change into centimeter. So because 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter, you will multiply 3 with 100, it will become 300 centimeter. Then B, 7 meter, similarly 7 into 100, it will be 700 centimeter. C, 17 meter. This you have to change into centimeter. Again, multiply with 100, it will become 1700 centimeter. Then D, 56 meter. Again, you multiply with 100, it will become 5600 centimeter. Now, second question. This also you have to change into centimeter. 5 meter, 90 centimeter, you have to change into centimeter. As you know, 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. So, 5 meter will be 5 into 100, that is 500 centimeter. 90 centimeter, it is already in centimeter, that you added with 500 centimeter, you will get 590 centimeter. Then B part, 28 meter, 75 centimeter. Same process you have to follow. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So, 28 meter will be 28 into 100, that is 2800 centimeter. Add 75 centimeter with it, it will become 2875 centimeter. Then C question, 35 meter, 18 centimeter. Now same process, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 35 meter will be 35 into 100, that is 3500 centimeter. Add 18 centimeter with it, it will become 3518 centimeter. Children, bigger meter is bigger unit than centimeter. If you compare it, so meter is bigger than centimeter. So whenever bigger unit is converted into smaller unit, we multiply. So here we are converting into smaller unit. So we are multiplying with 100. And the second unit is already given in the same unit, that you will add it. Now second D part question, 47 meter, 9 centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, so 47 meter will be 47 into 100, that is 4700 centimeter. Add 9 centimeter with it to it, it will become 4709 centimeter. Then 99 meter, 7 centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, 99 centimeter will be 9900 centimeter. Add with it 7 centimeter, you will get 9907 centimeter. So in this way, children, you will convert meters into centimeter. Fourth question, change into meters and centimeters. Now children, here you have to change into meters and centimeters. The question is given into centimeter, that you have to change into meters and centimeter. So from smaller unit to a bigger unit you are going. So you know 100 centimeters make 1 meter, or 1 meter has 100 centimeter. Because the question is given in centimeter, you have to change into meters and centimeter. You will divide 318 centimeter with 100. When you will divide, you will get the answer 3 meter 18 centimeter. How? See, you count down the number of zero given on the denominator side. So you will see 2 zero. So from the numerator part, you count down the two numbers from the right side. That will be your centimeter part, and before that number, that will be your meter part. So 18 centimeter and 3 meter. Or the other way of dividing, when you will find the quotient part is always has bigger unit and the remainder part has smaller unit. Now B part, 649 centimeter. Same way here also, you will write 100 centimeter makes 1 meter, and when you will divide with 100, you will get answer 6 meter 49 centimeter. Then C part, children, 508 centimeter. This also you divide with 100, you will get the answer 5 meter 8 centimeter. Okay, you divide it, you will get 5 as a quotient part, that will be your bigger unit, that is meter, 5 meter, and the remainder you will get 8 centimeter. So that is your remainder part. So in this way you will do the conversion. Children, now there is a homework for you. Exercise 16A, question 3, change into meters, and question 4, change into meters and centimeter. D to F part you will do yourself. Children, today we learned the introduction of length. How can we measure accurate length with the help of meter scale or measuring tape, and what kind of scales are there. Also, we learned the relation between the standard units of meter, centimeter and kilometer. and what is the relation we have between meters and centimeters, and the exercise based on meters and centimeters, and the conversion of meters. I hope you have understood and you do practice and do your homework. Rest part we will do tomorrow. With this, thank you.